Hey, what's up guys? Today we are going to learn Vox Twitter within 10 minutes. Yes, within 10 minutes.
If you don't have Vox Twitter add-on, you can pick it from my Google Drive. Make sure that your Vox Twitter add-on is enabled. To enable it, you can press this icon of Vox Twitter or simply by pressing hotkey Alt+W. You can find all the preferences in top panel or by pressing N to open toolbar. Here we also you can find same preferences of Vox Twitter. To draw any shape, simply click on left mouse button and drag mouse, then click at the end point. And then simply drag mouse further to make cut inside. To get in toolbar, press shortcut key D. With selecting circle, you can draw circle. The process of making circular cut is same as previous one. The next shape is N-gon. After selecting N-gon, we can draw custom shapes according to our need. To draw any shapes from its origin point, simply press and hold Alt key and draw the shapes. To draw symmetrical shapes such as perfect square, just hold down Alt and Shift key together while drawing. To add bevel, press B. It's add bevel to the edges. To resize bevel, just drag mouse, and to change the number of segments, just scroll the mouse wheel. We can add contour bevel by pressing Q and change it by dragging mouse and scrolling wheel. If you press tab while cutting, we can able to edit the shapes by moving these little dots. You're a superhero. We can also add bevel to the different shapes by same method. When we press T key, we can make boundary cut. Also, we can add bevel by pressing B during operation. By pressing 1, we can able to scale outer cube only. By pressing 2, we can scale both cubes together. By pressing 3, we can only scale inner cube. That's the hotkeys 1, 2 and 3. While cutting, if we press X, it adds slice cut through object. Adjust width of cut, press T to resize it. After deleting original cube, we can see the cut part of cube. If you press J during operation, we can find that the new cube is get joined to original cube. Duplicating cuts is our next step. After cutting shapes, to duplicate that, just hold down Alt key and double click on left mouse button. We can see the previous cut that we had made is get duplicated over the surface. If we want to duplicate many cuts together like this, draw square and press Y and drag the mouse through the cuts. Then duplicate it by simply left click and drag mouse to scale it. Also, we can rotate it by pressing R. We can also duplicate cuts using array. If we press V, it makes array of cuts. Drag mouse to change its position and scroll mouse wheel to increase or decrease their numbers. We can rotate it by pressing R. By unselecting cube, when we draw any shape, we found that it creates another separate object. Then we can cut or edit both objects separately. The important thing I forget to say, if we press Shift key while cutting, then we can able to edit it. The last thing is destructive and non-destructive modes. If we are non-destructive mode, after performing various operations on object, we found that in modifiers panel, nothing is applied on object. Still, we are able to edit it. Click on this arrow. It applies all the operations. If we did operations in destructive mode, we see that after performing operations, it get automatically applied on object. It's a simple example of destructive and non-destructive modes of operations. Here we end with box cutter. Hope you guys enjoy this tutorial. If you want to see such tutorials, comment me below and don't forget to subscribe.